Oh, whatever somebody did, that's
good. Can't get my shoes wet.
Yeah, I guess I've got to trial it. I've built it kind of by myself, so I've got the best understanding of it.
I said it's heavy.
I'm happy to go surfing and all that kind of thing. I just don't like looking underwater. So getting in a sub might be interesting.
Water's coming in. This is the worst feeling. I gotta concentrate. Hey, this is working. If I can get that nose down, we're laughing. It's not meant to be a fast process.
There was one test that they used to do to see whether you could take this. They'd take you down to the end of the jetty and you had to get into the gear and go down and sit on the bottom of the sea until your air ran out. It was at least 20 feet deep, maybe a little bit more. And you had to sit there and you were there for at least half an hour. It was quite a test because you couldn't see a thing, complete darkness, you couldn't hear anything, and you didn't know what in the hell was around you whatsoever.
We've got 3 days to deliver the finished product, and she's not going underwater. Things can't get much worse than this. Next thing I think, get some sandbags, some weights, throw them in there, and hopefully that'll bring her underwater.
We're taking on water. We are taking on water.
Holy shit, we're going down.
See you, Chuck.
See you, Chuck. Where's your
I've operated this Sleeping Beauty successfully in my own backyard. These Z Special Unit guys had to use this for real at war. The bravery's out of control, and that just gives you instantly a huge respect for them.
Thanks so much for coming over and seeing something that I've spent so much time building, and I mean, it was important then, and now to have you see it for real is it makes it very special.
Yeah, I want to thank you, Chuck, because I think you've done a remarkable job in reproducing one of those things that I thought had gone the way of all things.
He closes the valve and makes himself comfortable, steering for his rendezvous, and the operation ends.